وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about the relationship between fasting and patience. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he referred to the fasting of the month of Ramadan as الشهر الصبر. He referred to it as the month of patience. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم in two hadith. The first one is, he said, صوم شهر الصبر وثلاثة أيام من كل شهر صوم الدهر. The Prophet said, fasting in the month of patience and 3 days of every single month is like fasting the whole entire year. So as you can see in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he referred to fasting the month of Ramadan, he referred to it as شهر الصبر, the month of patience. In another hadith, he said, صوم شهر الصبر وثلاثة أيام من كل شهر يذهبن وحر الصدر. Fasting the month of patience, the month of patience, and 3 days of every single month, it will get rid of وحر الصدر, the whispers of الشيطان. So there's a strong bond between fasting and patience. There's a strong bond between the two. And patience is seen in the month of Ramadan in different forms and in different ways. For example, you leave off and you stay away from تَرْكُ مَحْبُوبَاتِ النَّفْسِ, things that your nafs wants. You have to be patient from that. You're not allowed to eat. You're not allowed to drink. You're not allowed to have sexual intercourse with your spouse. يعني the things that the nafs wants, you're prevented and you're prohibited from it. حِفْظُ اللِّسَانِ, you have to protect your tongue. Someone will say something evil to you, and then you would have to say to them, إِنِّي مُرْءٌ صَائِمٌ, I'm a fasting person, I can't say those things to you. It also comes in, مُجَاهَدَةُ النَّفْسِ عَلَى تَرْكِ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ, you have to strive within, you have to fight yourself in leaving of things which are haram, that the nafs is inclined to. And the fourth one is, الصَّبْرُ عَلَى مَشَقَّةِ الطَّاعَةِ, you also have to exert patience in doing the things that you were told to do by Allah Azza wa Jalla, and to stay away from the things that He told you to stay away from. And it's patience. And patience, my beloved brothers and sisters, is three types. As-sabru ala ta'atillah, you have to be patient upon the obedience of Allah. As-sabru anil ma'asiyah, to be patient from the sins. And the third one is as-sabru ala aqdarillahi al-mu'limah, to be patient from the calamities that you're put through in life. The trials and the tribulations, the calamities, to be patient from it and have forbearance and endurance. Patience is needed. ولذلك, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, مَا رُزِقَ عَبْدٌ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَلَا أَوْسَعَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ, a person is not being given something greater and even more vast than patience. يعني there is nothing greater and more larger and vast than patience. That's the best thing that can be given to you. Patience. Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he said, As-sabru sabran, patience is two. Sabrun inda al-musiba, patience when the calamity befalls. Sabrun inda al-musibati hasanun, he said, that the patience that you have to come with when calamities befall you, Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, this is good. Wa ahsanu minhu, Umar radiallahu anhu said, and better than that, is as-sabru an maharimillah. It is to be patient from the sins and the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited from you subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was once said to Ahnaf ibn Qays rahimahullah, innaka shaykhun kabir, you are an old man, wa inna as-sawma, and verily fasting, yahidduka, it's going to weaken you and it's going to destroy you. فَقَالَ, he said, إِنَّ الصَّبْرَ عَلَىٰ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ, to be patient upon the obedience of Allah, أَهْوَنُ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ عَلَىٰ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ, is easier to be patient than the punishment of the hellfire. To be patient upon the obedience of Allah is easier than to be patient from the hellfire. So fasting requires patience, and it's a month of patience. Hassan al-Basri, he said, الصبر كنز من كنوز الخير. Patience is a treasure from the treasures of good. لا يعطيه الله, Allah will not give it, إلا لعبد كريم, Allah will only give it to a honorable, righteous slave. That's the person that patience will be given to them. ولذلك إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Qur'an that He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will reward the people of patience بِغَيْرِ حِسَاب, without any accountability. يعني, there is no reward mentioned for the people of patience. And we know that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us that He's going to reward the people, the expectations is very high. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His treasures have no end. If a rich person said to you, I'm going to take care of you, and he's a rich, rich person, or he says to you, I'm going to make you happy. Imagine the richest of all riches, Allahu Azza wa Jalla. And there's nothing that we can compare Allah to. We expect from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that He's going to give us the ultimate. ولذلك سليمان بن القاسم, he said, كل عمل يعرف ثوابه إلا الصبر. Every good deed is known, its reward is known, except patience. It's not known. Allah has taken upon Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward those who are patient. We don't know what it is, but we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give them something very great. So this month, Shahru Ramadan, is a month where we need to strengthen our patience and show a lot of endurance. The hardship that come, the act of worship that we need to do, we need to multiply it this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those people who are able to do that. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله استغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.